Spaniel, while being trained, was repeatedly stomped and nearly killed by its owner. The dog survived, and its owner, Brendan Sheen, was convicted of animal cruelty. He was sentenced to 30 days in jail. By contrast, this teenage girl, Latasha Harlins, was shot and killed by a merchant in South Central Los Angeles. The merchant, Sue Ja Du, was convicted of voluntary manslaughter. Her sentence, 5 years probation, no jail time.
And it sends a bad message to the community that a human life is not valued.
Strange, very strange. Maybe that's our system, I don't know.
It's all corrupted. The judicial system is so corrupted.
Most people say unreal in comparison to Latasha Harlins. We say, unfortunately, very real for African Americans.
Even so, Judge Joyce Karlin's sentence in the Latasha Harlins case is being praised as courageous by the Criminal Courts Bar Association. At a news conference, defense attorneys criticized DA Ira Reiner for ordering his staff not to allow Judge Karlin to handle criminal cases.
He has abused his power as district attorney to, in effect, bully and attempt to intimidate every sitting judge who doesn't kowtow to his perception of justice.
How in God's name can I have our prosecutors go into court and ask for stiff sentences for violent criminals and then look the other way when there has been such a terrible miscarriage of justice?
On Friday, black community leaders have scheduled a march on the Compton Courthouse, where Judge Joyce Karlin's courtroom is located. Some are even considering picketing her home. They say something is terribly wrong when harm to this dog produced jail time and the death of Latasha Harlins did not. Brunel Chapman, Channel 4 News.
15-year-old Latasha Harlins was shot and killed by store owner Sue Jadu. Du claimed Harlins was stealing a bottle of orange juice when she confronted the teenager. The store security cameras captured the incident on videotape as Harlins repeatedly hits Du, who takes a gun from under the counter. Du claims she accidentally pulled the trigger, killing the teenager. Members of the black community charged the shooting was racially motivated. Du was convicted, but served no prison time. Du's store was later firebombed.
I would like for you, the black community, to see once again, I mean, you can have a black person killed with a video with eyewitnesses, and this is what you'll get.
Killed inside a Korean owned grocery store. And as Carrie Bergen reports, community leaders are using her death to send out a warning.
Mourners came by to pay their respects to Latasha Harlins, a 15-year-old girl gunned down in a Korean grocery store last weekend. The owner says she thought the girl was stealing a can of orange juice. Police say that does not appear to be the case. There have long been problems between blacks and Koreans in South Central, but Latasha's death has heightened tensions to explosive levels.
This store will never reopen, not in this community.
Today, black activists and friends and neighbors of the victim rallied outside the store that has not been open since the shooting.
No longer will we allow our young, beautiful black children to be killed.